Well, welcome to the 700 Club. With Thanksgiving on the horizon, today is Skinny Wednesday, and not a moment too soon. So we'll bring it on with ways you can help keep healthy, even though they're stuffing you at the table.
I always think, why be healthy during Thanksgiving? I know it's Skinny Wednesday.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, all right. Plus, Travis Stork from the hit show The Doctors. He's going to show you a miracle pill, one that's actually going to add years to your life. And best of all, it's free. That's going to be interesting.
But first in the news, this is a shocker. Mm-hmm. A paralyzed man from Belgium was misdiagnosed as being in a coma, one of those things, you know, like you can't get out of it. 23 years, he was alive, he was listening, he could understand, but he couldn't communicate. He was so frustrated. Until now, Dale Hurd has his story.
For 23 years, doctors believed Rom Hauben had no awareness of anything going on around him. But for 23 years, Rom was actually fully conscious and unable to let anyone know. Frustration is too small a word to describe what I felt, Hauben says, now using a keypad to spell out his words. I screamed, but there was nothing to hear. In 1983, Hauben was paralyzed in a car wreck. Doctors tried to communicate with him, but got nothing back and gave up. Then, after 23 years, Dr. Stephen LeRae scanned Hauben's brain and discovered that Hauben was fully conscious.
The big surprise was when we used this scanning machine that enables us to look into the brain and see the activity. He had a normal brain, and so that changed everything.
The discovery took place 3 years ago, but only recently came to light after publication of a study on the misdiagnosis of people with consciousness disorders.
Is Rom Hauben's case unique? Unfortunately, no. There are a lot of ROMs in the sense that a mistake was made in the diagnosis of a vegetative state. As I told you, our research has shown that 4 times out of 10, if we are not careful and don't use the appropriate measures, we can get it wrong.
Patients diagnosed as being in a vegetative state with no hope of recovery are sometimes allowed to die, which is what happened in 2005 to Terry Schiavo, the Florida woman at the center of the biggest right to die case in U.S. history. Her feeding tube was removed. Hauben suffers from what is called locked-in syndrome. His body is paralyzed, but his brain is fully alive. Rom Hauben says, I want to enjoy my life. Now that people know, I'm not dead. Dale Hurd, CBN News.
Thanks, Dale. Can you imagine? Can you imagine
that? I can't
that?
Imagine.
You're fully conscious. You know what's going on, and yet these people are all around you are doing things to you. Then they say, well, you're in a vegetative state, and we're going to leave you alone.
Well, that's the thing that's so interesting. You think about the whole thing with euthanasia, how so many people are like, okay, well, they must not be living. There's no brain activity. Let's just, you know, pull the plug.
Well, if they'd had the test like this on Terry Schiavo, the result may have been differently, but they starved that poor girl to death by court order. I mean, it was a horrible thing. So at any event, Rom Hauben is alive and has a computer to punch to get the answers, but maybe he'll get better beyond where he is now so he can move around.
We pray.
We pray for him.
Yeah.
Well, John Jessup has the rest of our top stories from our Washington Bureau. John?
Pat, many Americans say the stress of debt will make for a less cheery holiday season this year. An Associated Press GFK poll shows 93% of responders say they'll spend less or about the same as last year. Half say they're suffering at least some debt-related stress, and 22% say they're feeling it greatly or quite a bit. Well, another day and yet another record high for gold. The precious metal hit over $1,180. It's now up 11% in just over 3 weeks. Gold started its latest climb when India said earlier this month it had bought 200 metric tons. And another report today that India may buy more helped push gold to its latest record. Other central banks are gobbling up gold as the dollar continues to fall. Pat?
Well, if you're looking for another kind of currency, this is going to be it, a gold-backed currency of some kind, whether they call it a euro or whether they call it a dollar or a rupee or whatever. The countries are getting very nervous about what we're doing here in our nation. We have not managed our money supply well. We have not managed our economy well. gold is a refuge. And of course, coupled with that, you've got one of the largest economies in the world, their bank saying, well, we want to load up on it. So 200 tons and then another, whatever they're going to buy this time. That buoys the price of gold and people are flocking into it. But we told you on this program a year or so ago, months ago, that gold was going to go up over $1,000 an ounce. And the best thinking is now that it'll hit something like 1,360 before this particular run is over. But my prediction is it'll hit 1,800 or more. It could go over $2,000 an ounce before it's finished. Very interesting. And do you have your gold?
You
I keep asking and you haven't got any.
Because I need to be able to pay for the gold.
Well, of course. I mean, you can get a little ounce.
And I keep saying, Pat, we're good friends. Can't you just give me a bar?
A bar. I got a nice candy bar, protein bar. How'd you like that?
On that note.
Okay. Well, John, keep going. What do you got?
Pat, the New Hampshire Supreme Court has agreed to hear the case of a 10-year-old Christian girl forced to attend public school. A lower court had ruled that the girl could no longer be homeschooled by her mother. The parents are divorced. The court cited the father's concerns about the child's strong religious beliefs, saying public school would expose her to other points of view. Attorneys representing the mother say courts can settle disputes, but they cannot legitimately order a child into a government-run school on the basis her religious views need to be mixed with other views. That's precisely what the lower court admitted it is doing in this case. The lower court also said the girl's mother has more than kept up with the public schools in teaching her daughter. The battle to legalize same-sex marriage in two key liberal states seems to be stalling. Legislatures in New York and New Jersey have failed to schedule votes on bills to recognize those unions. The states are considered gay-friendly, but the most recent election cast doubt on whether same-sex marriage would pass anytime soon. New Jersey voters booted out their Democratic governor in favor of a Republican. And a shakeup in the New York legislature is causing the measure to flounder there. Analysts say a failure in these two states could hurt same-sex marriage nationwide. The biggest city in the country is getting some much-needed help this Thanksgiving. Master chefs from several states have united in New York to feed about 10,000 people in just 5 days. It's a ministry that's bringing food and evangelism together. Ephraim Graham has the story.
More than a million people in New York City struggle to put food on the table, and each day hundreds make their way to the Bowery Mission in Lower Manhattan looking for help. The mission's kitchen heats up even hotter around the Thanksgiving holiday, and that's where Florida chef Debbie Lowe comes in.
I have everything that I need. The things that we do for people that don't have the same thing that I have. Jesus loves me so much. I need to share that. I can't just keep it to myself. I have to share that.
It's Debbie's second year volunteering at the mission with Mercy Chefs, a team of some of the best cooks in the country who give up Thanksgiving at home to help the New York ministry move from feeding hundreds to thousands.
You know, you go to bed, you try to rest, and you're in your sleep like this because you're cooking. You wake up tired like you never went to bed.
Walter Taylor is a Virginia chef back for his second year of mobile kitchen duty in the Big Apple.
I've been doing this for years in the restaurants, and you know, people will tip you and compliment you and say nice things to you. And sometimes they're not really genuinely grateful for what you do, you know, but this is an opportunity to give to people. And when they say thank you or when they want to shake your hand, it's a different feeling.
The Bowery Mission has been serving hungry people here in New York City for more than 130 years. On average, it reaches about 800 people daily just here in Manhattan. But its goal has always been to serve people in all five boroughs. Mercy Chefs has come alongside and made that goal a reality. Chef Gary LeBlanc is seeing that another nearly 300 people are fed across the river in Brooklyn. He actually started Mercy Chefs after helping feed people in his hometown of New Orleans following Hurricane Katrina. He says it began with just 4 words from God.
Just go feed people. So it was an undeniable, audible call that I just had to be obedient to. You know, the Lord has provided everything that we've needed. We've only had to be faithful and mindful of His call.
The call to New York is 5 full days of nearly nonstop cooking and feeding.
Friday, we have an outreach in Chelsea Park, and it's literally as soon as that's over, we have to rush to the airport and jump on a plane. So we're going to go home just like this, smelling like turkey.
And the giving continues long after night falls on Mercy Chef's Thanksgiving week here in the city that never sleeps. The remaining 51 weeks out of the year, volunteer chefs are standing by, ready to respond to disaster.
We had one mobile kitchen in 2008. And that year, between the disasters we responded to and a couple of the outreaches we participated in, we fed 38,000 people in five disasters and two major outreaches.
In 2009, Mercy Chefs now has two mobile kitchens and even more volunteer chefs, like James Kelsey from New Mexico. This is his first mission. He's leaving with lasting memories that are sure to bring him back next year.
Shredding turkey and talking about Jesus, so yeah.
Turkey and Jesus. Now that's an unforgettable Thanksgiving meal. Ephraim Graham, CBN News, Brooklyn, New York.
Pat, Ephraim's story really seems to symbolize the true spirit of the Thanksgiving holiday.
There's no question. I think Mercy Chefs is doing a marvelous job. They did a good job in the New Orleans area, but they're really hitting their stride in this New York thing. The Bowery Mission has been feeding thousands, but now they've expanded, you know, the boroughs of New York. There are a lot of hungry people.
Well, I tell you what, and that food looks good. It looks really good. You know what's so cool is that, you know, the Lord wants us to do everything unto Him, but, you know, to do it in a way of excellence. So to have chefs do it, I tell you what a greater way to show the love of the Lord.
These just aren't some common, ordinary cooks.
No.
These are excellent chefs out of big-time hotels.
Absolutely.
Well, we're glad they're there, and we're glad for what they're doing. So that's a ministry that you can be proud of.
Absolutely. You know, many of us love the holiday season. But up next, the holidays are supposed to be the most wonderful time of the year for many of us. But some Americans, they're actually the worst.
Leading up to it, you just think it's going to be too painful. You can't handle it.
So get the cure for the holiday blues right after this.
Coming up later, the doctor's Travis Stork answers your medical questions.
At the end of the day, the most important thing for me is to make sure there's good, sound medical information. I'm hopefully helping people avoid their own trip to the ER someday.
Plus, Olympic legend Scott Hamilton talks about cancer and his new career.
I really embraced that in the second half of my life.
On today's 700 Club.
From best-selling author Jeanette.
Can you see it?
A cabin with curtains in the windows.
And acclaimed producer-director Michael Landon Jr.
Don't leave. Stay with me.
Comes the inspiring and heartwarming movie series that will captivate the entire family. Now available through this special TV offer, The Love Comes Softly DVD Collection. Katherine Heigl, Dale Nitkiff, Aaron Cottrell, and January Jones star in this original series that explores one family's journey from heartbreak to triumph in the rugged heartland of America.
I hope to be a doctor someday.
Why would a lady want to subject herself to such a taxing line of work?
Oh boy.
Eight unforgettable stories you and your family will enjoy together. And the series continues with the new release, Love Finds a Home, starring Hailey Duff and acclaimed actress Patty Duke.
The Lord says we are to forgive if we expect to be forgiven.
Call now to order Love Finds a Home on DVD for $17.95 and ask how you can get free shipping. Plus, find out how you can own the complete Love Comes Softly collection.
Tomorrow, it's as much a part of Thanksgiving as turkey and pumpkin pie.
It's sort of the opening act for Thanksgiving Day for a lot of American families.
Go behind the scenes at the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade. Plus, one of the greatest coaches of all time talks about the man who coached him.
A young guy about my age tapped me on the shoulder and said, I claimed that chapter in my life 6 months ago.
Tomorrow on the 700 Club.
Well, for the next 6 weeks, we'll give thanks, celebrate the birth of Christ, and ring in a new year. But for many, what's supposed to be the best time of the year isn't. Here's Laurie Johnson with a few tips on how to stay mentally healthy during the holidays.
Like millions of Americans, Karen McGrath dreads the holidays.
Leading up to it, you just think it's going to be too painful. You can't handle it.
Her son, Chandon, died 3 years ago in a diving accident, and both of her parents died a short time after that. Then came a divorce, which means her kids will spend much of the holidays with their dad.
There's a hole, there's an emptiness, there's a longing that You want to be with them instead of being left here.
And it's not just the absence of family that contributes to the holiday blues.
These holiday times, a lot of times, are tense. And there's a lot of angst regarding family members. If your family has been problematic all year long, most likely when they show up at your house, things are going to be problematic.
In addition to relationship problems, another source of sadness during the holidays is the belief that happiness is based on how much money we spend. And this year, with double-digit unemployment, there may be lots of folks who are feeling inadequate. Here are some ways to help beat the holiday blues. Plan ahead. Make a budget for gifts, travel, food, and donations. Schedule tasks like holiday baking and shopping so they're less stressful. Reach out, because focusing on someone else tends to lift your spirit and theirs. Churches, hospitals, and nursing homes all need volunteers this time of year. And bury the hatchet.
Even though that person is difficult and maybe even mean at times, you be the person of Christ to that person. You exercise grace. You exercise forgiveness. You give them the benefit of the doubt. And you do what Jesus said. You bless those who curse you. You love your enemies. You act like Jesus to that person, and you would be surprised at how far that can go in the long run.
Arrange get-togethers well in advance so you won't be caught alone. Isolation can lead to depression. If you can't be around loved ones, find new ways to celebrate together, such as sharing pictures, emails, or videos. And don't forget to exercise.
People who think exercise only benefits the body are really only seeing half the picture. The truth is, exercise is a powerful mood booster, a natural way to feel happy.
That's because during exercise, the body releases endorphins, neurotransmitters that have euphoric and pain-relieving properties similar to morphine.
If there's a day I'm having a bad day, I'm stressed out, I'm tired, sometimes working out reverses all of that. So I come into the gym, I forget about my problems, I concentrate on what I'm actually doing physically, and it helps me mentally.
Unfortunately, exercise is one of the first things skipped during the holidays. Some gyms offer incentives to keep members moving during the holidays. The YMCA is giving shirts to each member who works out at least 3 times a week. And the social interaction is an added bonus.
When somebody knows your name, it just feels good. It feels good to see somebody that you know. And with the small groups and small communities that we form here, people really have that sense of community.
Eat healthy, because overindulgence leads to feelings of guilt. Get plenty of rest so you're strong enough to meet the emotional demands while you're awake, and make time to pray daily.
Talking to God, slowing yourself down, allowing for quiet time, giving your mind a chance to rest in the Lord and really focus on who God is and what He says about you.
I mean, that's how else could I do it if I didn't have God? There's no way I'd be in a mental hospital.
So by taking spiritual and practical steps, you can enjoy good emotional health throughout the holidays. Lori Johnson, CBN News.
Some good advice, Lori. That's terrific.
Great advice, yeah. You know, Pat, one of my favorite Thanksgiving days was shortly after my divorce. I was kind of feeling that lonely feeling, too. And so I opened up my home to the singles in the church and the singles who I worked with. And I said, anybody who, you know, doesn't have a home to go to or whatever, yeah, come over to my house and I'll cook you a real Thanksgiving dinner with macaroni and cheese,
yeah,
and all the dressings. And so many people came. It was fantastic.
How wonderful.
And that was, and you know what was so neat? I had folks from different countries,
yeah,
because one, they didn't have family in the mm-hmm. area, and mm-hmm. they had never celebrated a traditional Thanksgiving dinner, and just different people. And it ended up being the best time of a medley of people that normally wouldn't be together that were able to give thanks.
Well, it may sound cliched, but it's more blessed to give than
yeah.
to receive. When you're giving, the blessing of God comes.
Yeah.
All right. Well, we're going to find out a doctor. He's going to give us some advice about what to do next.
Absolutely, Pat. He's a famous doctor, and he asks one simple question.
If I told you there was a miracle pill, it's free, it's going to add years to your life, it's proven to make you happier, it's proven to make you smarter, and you're going to enjoy it, would you take that?
Yes, definitely. Well, we're going to show you what this miracle pill is, so stay with us.
Over the last several months, we've been talking with everyone who has Medicare about the money-saving health plans from Humana. These are all-in-one plans that combine medical and prescription drug coverage, all with an affordable monthly health plan premium that may surprise you. If you have a separate drug plan with Original Medicare or with a Medicare supplement, you could be getting more benefits and saving money with Humana's Medicare health plans. Could Humana be a better value for your health care dollar? Call 1-888-411-8607. Or go online to humanafreebook.com and get this free booklet that will help you decide if our all-in-one plans are right for you. More than 1 million people have made the call and are enjoying Humana's all-in-one Medicare plans. The facts you need are in the book and it's totally free. Call 1-888-411-8607 or go to humanafreebook.com.
Well, Dr. Travis Stork is a real-life McDreamy. He's a former contestant on The Bachelor, an ER surgeon, and the co-host of the new show, The Doctors. Well, recently, he sat down with Mia Evans to give us a dose of some medical advice. Take a look.
If you'd asked me 5 years ago if I'd be sitting here talking to you, I would have said no way, no possibility.
How do you manage the schedule? Because you're working full-time here at Vanderbilt Medical Center in the ER, and you travel out to LA to host the show.
It's been the perfect balance because both jobs support one another. I couldn't really do one without the other.
Dr. Travis Stork splits his time between Nashville and LA. On the set of The Doctors, he's a natural, but he'll admit making the jump to TV was a rocky ride.
The very first day I walked out to host the show, you better believe I was scared because I'd never done it before. But over time, I've learned that if I do just act the same, whether there's a camera in front of me or not, people will see that this is me, this is just Travis. And then at the end of the day, the most important thing for me is to make sure there's good, sound medical information. I'm hopefully helping people avoid their own trip to the ER someday.
I know one way to prevent a trip to the ER has nothing to do with eating and exercise, but everything to do with your cell phone.
Texting while driving is essentially the same as drinking while driving. It's just so tempting. You get a text and you're tempted to look. On some days, 25% of the accidents we see are due to texting.
18 states in Washington, D.C. have already banned texting while driving.
You don't realize how easy it is to get in an accident when you're texting. It's not worth it.
Managing your stress level is another way to keep your health in check and stay out of the ER. Chronic stress can lead to high blood pressure, headaches, digestive problems, and weakening of the immune system.
How do you manage the level of stress that you must handle every day, and what do you do to personally stay healthy?
We're all prone to stress. We're all busy. And it's really what we do in our own lives, the choices we make that we do have control over, and it's how active we are. And every time we sit down to eat a meal, that's impacting our lives, it's impacting our stress, and it's impacting how long we're gonna live.
A recent national survey revealed that 72% of the adult population are either overweight or obese or morbidly obese, and that was on the CDC website.
Obesity is such a rampant problem. It's increasing in prevalence so much because we live rather sedentary lives. We spend a lot of time on the computer, watching TV. Some of the foods that we eat on a regular basis, they lead to heart attacks, diabetes, high blood pressure, and early death. The problem is our human bodies are not designed to live this way. And so the beauty is it's reversible. Fill your life with fruits and vegetables and whole grains. And whatever ones you like, choose them. Don't eat things you don't like. Eat things you enjoy. If I told you there was a miracle pill, it's free. It's gonna add years to your life. It's proven to make you happier. It's proven to make you smarter. And it's proven to make you a better spouse, a better parent, a better person. Would you take that?
Yes, definitely.
And you're gonna enjoy it. That's what being active is. It's not exercise, it's being active. Whatever it is that you like to do, be active. If it's just a walk with your husband, with your kids, because every time you're active, you're giving your heart a workout.
With all the news about the swine flu outbreak, what is it that you want to tell families about being prepared for this flu season?
Well, this is a flu season that could be particularly bad for both seasonal flu cases, which is the traditional flus that we get vaccinated for, and H1N1, otherwise known as swine flu. So people this year do have to get
two vaccines if they want to be protected against the seasonal flu and the swine flu. They're two separate vaccines. And if we're smart, you can actually avoid the swine flu, the regular flu, and the common cold just by making simple changes. Washing your hands regularly for about 20 seconds and not touching your eyes, your mouth, or your nose.
For parents who do have a child who's sick with the flu, what do they do?
Keep them hydrated, keep their fevers down. Watch your child, pay attention. If your child's not breathing right, if they're getting blue around their lips, if they're not feeding, then you need to take them to the doctor or take them to the ER. But what I say to every parent is, if your child gets the flu or you get the flu, it's not a time to panic. Call your doctor and they can give you some guidance. But most kids are doing great with this.
Great, helpful tips.
Oh, what a nice, and he was a contestant on The Bachelorette.
I know. I wonder if someone snatched him up. You think, Pat?
I don't think he's been snatched yet.
Well, good to know. Anyway.
Mark up one ER doctor. All right.
Well, for more Travis Stork, all you have to do is just check out his show called The Doctors, or you can always log on or head over to CBN.com to find your local listings. I think I'm a little bit beklempt over that little statement.
All right. Keep going. You're doing fine.
I'm going to keep going.
All right.
And if the doctor didn't answer your questions, Pat's gonna. So stay tuned with Bring It On, because Susie writes, my family really loves chocolate. I've heard some types of chocolate are good for you. What are some of the things that I should look for? Well, we're going to answer Susie's question and so much more, so don't go away.
Still ahead. It wasn't winning the gold or beating cancer. Scott Hamilton tells us about the hardest thing he's ever done in his life.
It's been a year of just trying to teach my body how to do this again, and it's difficult.
Plus, meet the natural bodybuilder of the decade.
Winning became my family. It became everything to me.
And find out what the strong man was trying to hide.
If I could build this armor around myself, then nobody could hurt me again.
These are the new Bose Quiet Comfort 15 noise-canceling headphones, engineered to make air travel quieter, more relaxing, and to make listening to music more enjoyable. Bose was the first to introduce noise-canceling headphones over 20 years ago, and now QC15 headphones set an entirely new standard. Seth Porges of Popular Mechanics states that compared to the competition, the QC15s are vastly superior. Mark A. Kellner of The Washington Times says they reproduce music with extreme clarity, fidelity, and definition. And with a very comfortable fit, you won't find any other headphones like them. When you fly, engine roar fades away. You'll also hear a lifelike music reproduction you may never have experienced. Try QC15 headphones for 30 days risk-free with free shipping. Compare them to any other headphones and judge for yourself. New Quiet Comfort 15 headphones. Performance that's only from Bose.
Welcome back to Washington for this CBN News Break. A big book debut for former Alaska Governor Sarah Palin. Palin's book, Going Rogue, has sold more than 700,000 copies in just its first week of release. The memoir came out on November 17th with a first printing of more than 1.5 million copies. Now, publisher HarperCollins announced it will print about another million copies. Well, tomorrow's Thanksgiving, and with the downturn in the economy, millions of Americans will find it challenging to feed their families, and CBN's Operation Blessing is there to help. The aid organization distributes food through 5,200 partnering ministries across the U.S., like this one in hard-hit North Carolina. The Outreach Center picks up food from Operation Blessing's Bristol, Virginia distribution center every month. OB provides as much as 75% of the center's food items. More than 1,200 American families are fed every week through this one ministry alone. This most recent distribution will go a long way to help families have a happy Thanksgiving. You can find out more by going to Operation Blessing's website at OB.org. Pat and Christy will be back with more of the 700 Club right after this.
Everywhere I turn, people are talking about gold prices. Gold has risen to new records. Gold prices have tripled in value since 2001. Gold is up almost 40% in the past 2 years. That's right, 40%. Not many investments competed with that type of performance during the same period. Isn't it time you add gold to your portfolio? I'm a Goldline client and I've been investing in gold for over 10 years. If you're thinking about investing in gold, I recommend you call Goldline now and speak with an account executive. They'll walk you through the steps to get started and answer any questions you may have. It's easy to own gold. Learn how you can acquire physical gold that is delivered directly to you. Call Goldline, a company with more than $500 million in annual sales, helping investors like you and me acquire gold for nearly 50 years. Call today and get your free investor's kit and learn why you should own gold.
All over the world, there are minds to inspire and opportunities for change. At Regent University, we prepare you to become a Christian leader and guide others in all walks of life. And with online classes from Regent, you can change the world. From anywhere in the world, Regent University, online education with a solid foundation. Visit anywhere.regent.edu or call 866-REGENT-U to request your welcome kit. Thanksgiving is one of the best times of the year when we remember God's blessings with the people we love. 700 Club Partners, this year you can make CBN's Great Is Thy Faithfulness a part of your celebration. Your Thanksgiving gift brings life-changing help to people in need. You feed the hungry all around the world, including those here at home. Watch for this mailing. Remember God's blessings and send in your gift. Serve up God's love this holiday season. Give so others can know God's faithfulness. It's like inviting the world to your Thanksgiving table.
Well, folks, I want you to know that this is coming to you in the mail if it hadn't already gotten there. Please open it. Please pray about it. Please send in the best gift you can. Because, I mean, we're looking at Christmas. This is the birthday of Jesus. Let's give him our best gift. And when you think of Thanksgiving, figure out how much you are spending or have spent on your Thanksgiving dinner, and then write a check in that amount or more and send it in to Operation Blessing to CBN, and we're going to help as many people as we can this Christmas holiday time. Let's bring joy to the hearts of those who are hurting.
Absolutely, Pat.
Okay.
Are you ready to rock and roll with that? Bring it on.
Rock and I'll roll.
Okay,
so
the very first question is from Susie. He says, the holidays are coming and my family really loves chocolate. I've heard that some types of chocolate can actually be good for you. What are the benefits of chocolate, and is there a certain type I should look for?
Well, Susie, chocolate is indeed good for you if it's the right kind of chocolate. What it'll do is open up your blood vessels to lower your blood pressure. It will quiet you if you've got stress, and it'll keep you well in a good frame of mind. But that is dark chocolate. The so-called milk chocolate that you find in the Hershey bars and so forth have got about, well, it has maybe 10, 15% chocolate, and the rest is sugar and milk and so forth. That's not what you're looking for. You want chocolate, and you can get bars in health food stores, and I'm sure in various other places, that go 72 to 75 to 80% chocolate. And when you get those, that's the good stuff. But it'll say dark chocolate, not milk chocolate. And that's what you look for.
Well, you know, everybody knows that I love chocolate.
All right.
So yesterday I was in editing, working on a story, and this is what my editor had. I want you to see this and listen to it. Can you hear it? It says,
I love chocolate.
I love chocolate.
It says, hold on. I love chocolate.
And then on the front of it, can you see it says chocolate rules? This says, no, chocolate lover's rule. Are you a chocolate lover, Pat?
Dark chocolate.
Well, see, it's a combination, milk and dark. Good team.
Milk is
love
not
that.
Good. Dark you want. All right. What else?
Yes. Milk is good, too. Okay.
Right.
Linwood writes in and says, Pat, my family has a history of health problems, including strokes and heart disease. I'm trying to do what I can to stay healthy and hopefully avoid this in my life. I already exercise regularly and would like to know what foods you would recommend to help fight against heart disease and stroke.
Okay. Stay off of processed fats. Stay off of that which has high cholesterol. But, you know, sausage and pork products, things like that, are not good for you. Same thing is true with things that have larded beef. You know, you get prime cuts. That's the one that's got all the fat in it, and that will hurt you. So strict, if you're really concerned about it, hold it down, if you can, to chicken and turkey, that kind of thing, and fish. Eat lots of fresh fruit and vegetables, and don't cook with butter and so forth. Try something like, if you can, I would recommend a couple of tablespoons a day of fish oil or omega-3 unsaturated oil, which you find in flaxseed. So that helps clean up the arteries. The other is a few tablespoons of lecithin in your drink. Lecithin has a way of emulsifying the stuff in your arteries. So that's a start.
That's a great start. And, of course, exercise regularly.
Well, she said she exercised, so by all means, keep on exercising.
There you go. Okay. Well, Pat, recently I broke out in severe hives after I had a bottled fruit drink. My doctor said it was an allergic reaction to an ingredient in the drink, more specifically, the red dye ingredient called, is it Carmen? Carmen? What is it? What is in Carmen? I don't know if I said it right. Sure. That would cause me to have such a severe reaction.
Carmen is red, and it's ground up Peruvian beetles.
What?
Who eat red cactus berries. And they take those beetles and grind them up and then put them in these various preparations to make them red.
Oh, my Lord.
So you didn't know you were getting it.
I didn't know I was eating beetles. Well, if I would have known I was eating beetles,
you
probably
wouldn't have eaten any beetles. I mean, nobody wants any of them there beetles.
Beetles? But, yeah. I'm from New Jersey, all of a sudden I sound country.
Beetle juice coming out of your mouth. By the way, you know, that there's a galaxy or, you know, star called Betelgeuse. But in any event, that's why, you know, this stuff can give strokes. Mm. Allergic reaction can even kill you. Now, the FDA has finally made manufacturers, they used to put natural ingredients. Mm-hmm. I mean, ground up beetles and natural ingredients.
But well, it's natural.
Now you have to, they'll have to put Carmen. I tell my wife, and I'll tell all of you ladies, read the labels on what you buy in the grocery store. Read the labels.
I think just the simplest thing to do, Pat, is to always shop on the perimeter of the grocery store, because that's where you've got the fruits, the vegetables, and just all the
and
natural
no
things.
Peruvian red
no
beetles.
No beetles.
No beetles. All right, that's what the problem is. That's why you had a violent reaction. And you can have a stroke, and you can die eating those things. Not many, but a few. It has been known.
Okay, this is such a random thought. But you know me, Pat. What? There used to be a show called Fear Factor years ago.
Yeah.
And they, did you ever watch it?
Oh, it's disgusting.
I loved it, though.
You loved it?
I loved it, because they would eat things like beetles and worms and cow testicles and things of that sort.
Cow testicles? Is that what you just said? Did I?
They would eat cow testicles.
Oh, please. And then you're going to tell me about mac and cheese for Thanksgiving. Okay, it's just too much. I can't stand it. What else?
We're going to switch gears now. And we're going to go.
What's the next
thing? I don't know. Well, okay, four. Becca, recently I received a house plant as a gift. My friend told me that some plants can actually make people healthier. Is that true?
Without question. They take the toxic material in the air and process it harmlessly. They can lower the, at least they raise the humidity, not lower it. And so if you got a dry heat, which makes your nose subject to disease, the plant will bring moisture into your house. Not to mention the fact that it's restful. You
it
got
is.
A plant. You can talk to the plants.
Do you talk to your plants?
No. But my son used to talk. He had a plant that he talked to.
Which son? Is it Gordon so I can
no,
mess with him?
No, it's Tim.
Oh, okay. Well, I was like, oh, good, I can mess with Gordon.
But, you know, they are sensitive. Plants can understand if you say nice things to them.
Hmm.
And if you curse them, they'll get sick.
Jesus did it.
That's right. So be nice to your plants.
I'll be nice to my plants.
And stay away from beetles, and please don't eat any of those terrible things that she was talking about earlier. All right, go on.
Okay. Well, when Scott Hamilton won the Olympic gold medal, it marked the end of his long journey to the top of the figure skating world. But a longer and harder journey actually was yet to take place, one Scott would have to face with the rest of his family.
Since gliding his way into millions of homes during the 1984 Olympics, Scott Hamilton has become synonymous with figure skating. Despite his success, some recent career challenges and a battle with cancer had Scott skating on thin ice. But this Thanksgiving, he returns to the rink with Christy Yamaguchi, Dorothy Hamill, and others for Kaleidoscope, a national television special to support cancer research. Scott talked with me at his home in Nashville about his triumph over cancer, his new family, and his faith.
Losing my mother to cancer put me into the cancer community. We started fundraising within a year of her passing, and it changed my life forever. Having cancer myself, I realized that there are issues in this community that really need to be addressed. I thought with support, education, and obviously the never-ending funding of research, that needs to be helped as well. So with Kaleidoscope on Ice, the show that's coming up, and with Santa Fe Venice and their pharmaceutical company and their commitment to this event of raising awareness for all women's cancers, it's just a thrill to be able to participate in things like this.
How difficult was it getting back into shape?
It was the hardest thing I've ever done in my life. You know, it's been a year of just trying to teach my body how to do this again, and it's difficult. I mean, I forgot just how long it takes to accumulate the strength and the timing and the rhythm and that quickness that you need and the stamina that you need to pull this stuff off.
When you went into retirement, you said that you felt like you lost your significance.
Yeah.
Do you feel like you recovered that?
You know, it's like that midlife thing. You know, it can be really destructive or it can be really constructive. For me, it was, you know, getting married, starting a family, and yeah, I got baptized and I committed myself spiritually and I really embraced that in the second half of my life.
How has your relationship with God grown through all of this?
For me, I really feel like every day is a learning experience. And when I told Tracy, my wife, that I had a brain tumor, she didn't stop and say, oh, or anything. She just looked at me, grabbed my hands, and started to pray. And I realized that that's the only place to go, because that's where it all happens. And it was a real strong, amazing moment in my life. You know, I'll say that, you know, a glass shattered will never do what it did before, but if you hold it up to the light, it can make rainbows. It can create beauty that it couldn't do before. So scars are much stronger tissue than what it replaced. It'll never cut there again. You know, it's these are things that when you look at them from a different angle, it gives you great strength. And I guess my place in a lot of this is to say, okay, I've had a childhood illness that made me the littlest one in my class, no health, and I got through that. I got through failing in skating. I've got through loss of my parents. I've gotten through broken relationships. I've gotten through cancer and chemotherapy and surgery. And I've chosen to really love life like I've never loved it before.
When Scott recently participated in a cancer benefit in Cleveland, his first appearance in 5 years, he wasn't sure what to expect.
I never thought I'd be back there again. And it was such an incredible realization that everyone there, you know, really wants to be lifted up. They want a great moment in their lives. They want to share in something that makes them feel good and more powerful and that they can actually do this. And, you know, it's extraordinary. It's an extraordinary opportunity just to look at a cancer patient and say, I admire you.
What kind of legacy do you want to leave behind?
Whatever I accumulate as far as recognition or awards, if I can inspire people to better lives, great. That'd be really wonderful. But ultimately, it's how I raise my boys. Every night, my head hits the pillow, and I thank him for Tracy and for the boys. And I say, I'm giving them to you. And I want them to embrace you and to live their lives by you, through you, with you. Every night, I thank God for these boys and the life that I've been given.
You know, I've always admired Scott and his wonderful gifts on the skating rink, but now I tell you, I admire him even more just for his faithfulness and courage just with the Lord. Isn't that awesome, Pat?
He is one of the nicest people. He's so humble,
yeah,
and he's so yielded to the Lord. I mean, it's just a thrill to be in his presence. So I'm delighted that he's going to be skating. I understand Thanksgiving, they've got Legends of Skating, and they've got Fox's Kaleidoscope. That's going to be Thanksgiving Day at 4 p.m. But Scott Hamilton, a marvelous guy, and to overcome what he has overcome is extraordinary. So keep praying for him, and we congratulate him.
Amen.
Wonderful man.
Absolutely.
Well, up next, the day Mr. Universe conquered the world.
I wish that I was dead that day. I can remember standing and looking in the mirror saying, I hate you. Why would a person give you the time of day? I hate you.
See why his big win wasn't enough right after this.
If you have diabetes, you could eat this, but wouldn't you rather enjoy this? Hi, I'm Nicole Johnson, Miss America 1999. I've had diabetes for over 15 years. I got all these yummy recipes in my Better Care cookbooks. And if you have diabetes and have Medicare or qualified insurance, you can get these cookbooks free.
Call now for not one, not two, but three free cookbooks. To qualify, call 1-800-765-8132.
Enjoy mouth-watering recipes like this rich chocolate cake, plus oven-fried chicken, nachos, and more. You also get this free meal planning guide and this free diabetes magazine. So call now for your free Better Care Kit with three free cookbooks.
To qualify, call 1-800-765-8132. That's 1-800-765-8132.
Well, welcome back. Ron Williams devoted his entire life to bodybuilding. So when he won the title of Mr. Natural Universe, it should have been one of his greatest moments. Instead, it turned out to be one of his worst.
What kind of drive must a person have to sculpt their body into a human masterpiece? How much dedication does it take for someone to win over 250 awards for bodybuilding? For Ron Williams, one thing drove him to succeed: fear.
One reason bodybuilding really intrigued me so much is because if I could build this big, strong body, this armor around myself, then nobody could hurt me again.
Because hurt was all Ron knew his entire life.
Probably one of my earliest memories, Christy, is this. Sitting on a doorstep, waiting for my mom to come and pick me up after being dropped off, and the devastation of her never coming back.
Abandoned at 4 years old, Ron was shuffled from house to house, often left with people who told him he was a burden, unwanted, or simply just another mouth to feed.
I felt like if my mother didn't love me, my biological father didn't love me, then how in the world could anybody else love me?
And to make matters worse, for over 9 years, Ron was raped and molested in some of those homes.
I was in such pain that the thought of not living was comforting. And I was suicidal at 13 years old. My whole young life was a life of depression.
The only time Ron felt any sense of self-worth was when he played sports.
I would watch people, how they interacted with winners. And I made my mind up early. I want to be that person who wins. And winning became my family. It became everything to me. It became life and death for me.
Ron excelled at every sport, but one he mastered, bodybuilding. It became his obsession. And in 1988, he won the coveted title of Mr. Natural Universe. But his reaction to his big win wasn't what he expected.
I wish that I was dead that day because I realized, regardless of how many contests I could win or how many Mr. Universe competitions I could put under my belt, it was not going to be satisfying. I can remember standing and looking in the mirror saying, I hate you. Why would a person give you the time of day? I hate you.
No matter what he did, he couldn't erase the hurtful memories and questions that haunted him every day of his life.
And I thought, what was so ugly about me that I'm the one that was taken away? I thought she didn't love me. I thought she gave me away. I thought that I wasn't good enough.
Ron was a ticking time bomb, and although he tried to mask his hurt behind a tough exterior, the anger and rejection grew worse. especially when he came across one particular kind of person.
When I saw Christians, I would duck and run because they would always come to me and say, if you died today, where do you think you would go? I said, I'd go to hell, you know. Why are you talking to me about this? Do you know that God loves you? And I said, you know what? I've got real problems. I don't want to hear about God right now. I mean, I was angry with God. I didn't want to hear anything about God. If God loved me, like all of these Christian people would say, why did he allow all of the pain and suffering to come into my life? Mm. When he could have stopped it. So I felt like he was directly the cause of it, that it was me against the world and against God. To be honest with you, I hated God.
Although Ron claimed he hated God, in his heart, he knew that God was the only one who could answer his questions.
I began to want to find out who am I? What is my significance? Why was I ever here? And in my apartment, I dropped to my knees and I began to weep. I hadn't wept probably in 10 or 11 years.
That night, Ron asked God to forgive him for the hate he harbored in his heart and to show him how to live a life right before the Lord.
God baptized me in the Holy Spirit right there in my apartment. And he began to tell me and teach me how to live. And this was a process because once he saved me, my spirit was fine, my body was still the same, and my mind was the same. So now that I've been born again, that's a spiritual birth. But he says, it's your job to renew your mind to the mind of Christ. He said, you can no longer believe what people have said about you. You can no longer believe what you think about yourself. And so I started at that point reconditioning my mind to believe what God had to say.
He did that by reading his Bible to see who God said he was. He prayed and fasted on a regular basis, and little by little he began to learn God's heart and how much God loved him.
When I accepted Christ in my life, one of the first things I learned is you got to forgive. I said, forgive? Forgive my mother, forgive my father, forgive all these people that have hurt me. Why would I ever do that? So they could hurt me again? I'm not going to forgive. They don't deserve my forgiveness. Little did I know that the forgiveness was for me. That if I wanted to be whole, that I had to release all of that hurt and pain. And so I went on this quest to forgive, and I would say the words, Christy, I forgive, I forgive. And I love you, and I love you. But the hurt was bigger than me. And so all of my forgiveness wasn't enough because the pain was still there. I didn't have the capacity to truly forgive. So I remember one day, I went before God in prayer, and I said, God, I'm tired of this hurt. I'm tired of this pain. I'm tired of the pain that has been inflicted on my life, continuing to control my life. And I said, I don't have the capacity to forgive. Give me your forgiveness. And when I said that, something rushed through my body, and it was like I was born again all over again. Everything looked new and different, and the pain was gone for the first time. I could look back and I could see all the things that had happened to me, and there was just no pain. It was like watching a movie screen of my past, but there was no pain attached to it.
Today, Ron is a completely different person. He travels the country as a motivational speaker, a pastor, and a fitness expert. But he says his greatest accomplishment came when he stood face to face with his own mother.
She said, but baby, you got something different. And I led her to the Lord. And that was probably one of the greatest days of my life is leading my mother to the Lord.
And in his continuing journey towards complete healing, Ron has learned one of the greatest keys in life.
God loves us, and he wants the best for us. I'm living proof of that. Just give him a chance.
What a story. God wants what's good for you. God wants what's good for me. And Ron Williams found it. Can you imagine overcoming the hurt and the anger? The things that were done to him as a little boy, I mean, he could have been just seething with anger. He could have been a member of a gang. He could have been somebody just on a tirade to kill and hurt people. Instead of that, he's tender-hearted and he's loving because he has met the Savior. And all that he has accomplished, all that Mr. Natural Universe, which is quite a prize, is nothing compared to the fact that Jesus Christ loves him. And let me tell you, Jesus loves you. And he died for you. And this Thanksgiving and this Christmas, just keep in mind that amidst all the, whether or not you're up or down, whether you've lost your job or whether you've got a big one, whether you have lost a lot of money or whether you're rolling in riches, doesn't matter. God died for you. And if you will receive him, he will come into your heart and he'll give you a brand new life. Ron found it. He's been transformed. Scott Hamilton found it. He's been transformed. God loves you. And if you want his love, you have to ask for it. You have it, but you need to ask that he would come and take over. So if you will pray with me, I'm going to lead you in a prayer. You pray with me and watch what God's going to do. Don't be afraid. God loves you. Just bow your head and pray these words. Lord Jesus Christ. That's right, pray with me. Lord, you know what's been done to me. You know the suffering and you know the pain. But Lord, right now, I know that you died to give me a new life. And so I turn to you, Lord, at this moment, and I give you my life. Come into my heart, Lord Jesus. Live your life in me, and I will live for you, and I will serve you all the days of my life. Thank you, Lord, that you've heard my prayer. And thank you, Lord, that you've come into my heart. And Father, for those who prayed with me just then, let the power of God fill them from this moment on. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, if you prayed with me, I want to give you a gift. This is something called A New Day. It has in it a CD with teaching, 73 minutes of teaching that'll tell you what it is that you've done and what the Lord wants to do for you in the future. What about the second coming of the Lord? What about being baptized in the Spirit? It's all here. In addition to that, there's a little booklet of Bible verses that you can refer to that'll help you. I want you to call in right now, 1-800-759-0700, and just say, look, I prayed with that guy on TV. I prayed with Pat. I gave my heart to the Lord, and I just want to receive this little packet called A New Day. And I want you to know that I am rejoicing in Jesus. 1-800-759-0700. Toll free, no charge. It's all free. The Lord loves you. Well, we leave you today with these words from Psalm 28. The Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart trusts in him, and I am helped. Well, that's all the time we've got for this show. For John and Christy and all of us, this is Pat Robertson saying, may the Lord bless you, give you a happy Thanksgiving, and as the holidays come in, may it be a time of joy for you and your family. We'll see you next week. Bye-bye.
Hi, this is Terry Musin. I have the privilege of traveling around the world seeing the life-changing things CBN partners make possible. On a recent trip to South Africa, I saw firsthand the incredible difference you're making in orphans' lives. Here at home and across the nations, you are bringing the help people so desperately need. Just like you did when you provided food for over 600 families in Tulsa, Oklahoma. And each month you feed over 3 million hurting Americans in cities all across our nation. For many, you provide the only way they can feed their children. Your monthly gift makes it possible to heal the sick, feed the hungry, preach the gospel, and so much more. Please watch for this mailing and send in your pledge.
Imagine lifting a life out of despair and filling it with hope. That's what you do every day as CBN Partners, and it only happens because you were there.